Today, in case it has somehow escaped your notice, is officially World Emoji Day, according to those who decide and decree such things anyway. For younger generations fluent in the symbology, those brightly coloured icons add depth to their digital communications. For the older amongst us, though, well, they can cause more confusion than clarity. And, of course, it's in our workplace that this range of comprehension can result in some challenges, some tests, some confusion. Joining us from Wellington to explain emojis and to talk through the findings of a new survey about their use is Victoria University's Linguistics Professor, Miriam Meyerhoff. Professor Meyerhoff, it's so good to have you with us this morning.
John.
I'm going to do embarrassed face now.
Actually, you need to take your glasses off.
I know, because I attempted linguistics when it was just embryonic at Victoria University in the 80s.
Good for you.
I was studying English Lit, but... That you will be the brightest woman in the university if you're a professor of linguistics, right? Your IQ will be about 600 or 700. So why are you studying emojis?
Oh, I actually think emojis are pretty interesting because we know that a lot of language symbols, like, you know, orthographies, you know, spelling systems that we have today, grew out of representations, pictorial representations. But we don't have a time machine to be able to go back and see what people were doing, you know, 5,000 years ago. But we've actually got some data now with this kind of new symbolic system that's emerging. And we can see how people negotiate, how some stuff gets dropped out because it's actually not very functional, but then other stuff ends up surviving and turning out to be, you know, sort of an integral part of communication. So actually I see it as being very, very core linguistics. Yeah.
Whoa, okay. And the other thing is, I've always been fascinated by this. If you want to know how the English middle classes are going to talk, right, you listen to how the English middle classes are going to talk in 20 years, you listen to how Cockneys are talking now, right? And so people who are using emojis now aren't actually doing anything that the rest of us won't be doing, even elderly people, in the not-too-distant future.
Yeah, well, there's two things that happen. Of course, elderly people die off, and so the younger speakers or the younger people who are using emojis are the ones who become the older speakers, who are the ones using it in the future. Sorry, it happens to everybody, John. But, you know, that's part of it. But, yeah, you're right. They do. Young people do tend to lead, and actually specifically young women, and that's what we're seeing in this survey that 2Degrees have done. We've got more young women using emojis on a regular basis than men. So it looks as though it's a fairly canonical case of language change.
Yeah, which is exciting, isn't it?
And it's so, very exciting. Yeah.
So if you are a miserable old stick in the mud and you see an emoji in an email you're receiving, just something as simple as a smiley face, what do you do? How do you respond?
Well, the survey tells us that most people, if it's in a workplace communication, if you're over the age of about 55, think that it looks either unprofessional or incompetent. So, you know, you want to be careful who you're addressing these things to. But the survey also tells us that people know that because implicitly people are using emojis mainly with people that they know quite well already. They're not firing it off to people that they hardly know.
Okay, so the emoji users are worldly, and if they're applying for a job or a promotion or a raise and they're sending it to some miserable old bugger who's their boss, they're not going to put emojis in their emails by and large.
You would hope not. Yeah, it seems that they do seem to realise that. Because they also tell us that they, even when they're sending emojis amongst their friends and family, they have to explain them. Younger people who are the peak emoji users say that they have to explain 2/3 of their emojis that they use with their friends and family. So, you know, it's a very creative and a very productive space, but it's also a very chaotic space at the moment.
There's joy in the chaos, isn't there? And so... The other one is I like the fact that there are skin colour emojis, right?
Yeah.
So at first, everyone, so if you gave a thumbs up emoji, they were kind of all white, and thank goodness we're
very...
So emojis are actually taking stock of the world they exist in.
Yep, that's right. And so people are using, there's a reasonable number of people who are using the little New Zealand flag as a New Zealand emoji. But, you know, there seems to be some kind of demand for a nice cute kiwi bird. I think that there would obviously be potential there. But as I say, there's the stock and trade ones like smiley face and sad face, which seem to do the most of the work at the moment.
Mm. Are they sometimes passive aggressive? And so you get an email from someone that telling you you're a total dick, and then there's a smiley face at the end. And if that's the case, does the smiley face mitigate or reduce the insult and injury that has just been suffered?
Oh gosh, John, I don't know. Have you ever gotten a passive aggressive email?
More than once.
Yeah, I wonder if you'd need an emoji to do that. Sure. I mean, they're part of the linguistic system, and people like them because they're giving this sort of thing that tone of voice can otherwise do for you.
Right.
Because when you're writing, you don't have tone of voice. So sure, people can can use them ironically, people can use them to be sarcastic, people can use them to be passive aggressive, and that's presumably where a lot of the confusion arises. And quite a few people get into trouble for using them. So 50% of the people that responded to the survey, and it's across the whole country, rural and urban, say that they've had misunderstandings with emojis, and 17% say that they've actually gotten into pretty big trouble because of it. Yeah.
17%, so almost one in five.
Exactly, yeah.
And what sort of trouble do they get into, last question?
They didn't ask that. But this is the sort of thing we can now go out and find out.
If it's one final question, I've been given the rap seven times, but I'm enjoying your company so much. If you send an email to another linguistics professor, say at Harvard or Oxford or the London School of Economics or whatever, would you include an emoji in it?
Only if I know them. And I did send one to a professor at La Trobe over the weekend with a little, you know, sort of like vomity face because I was talking about having to take over somebody else's teaching for a little while. So, yeah, but I know him really well, yeah. But I wouldn't send it to some random person in Oxford.
Right. Excellent.
And so that's funny because the vomity face just expresses so much more than saying you're a bit pissed off about this.
Yeah, vomity face, bleh. There's no vomity face coming back from the studio to you, Victoria, University Professor in Linguistics, Professor Miriam Meyerhoff. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
That was my pleasure.
It was a delightful interview. Smiley face from all of us.